Hi there! Recently I started working with a microcontroller NI52 from Nordic Semiconductor. Those are really nice and really fun, and you got many ways of actually playing with them. For example, you got the development kit, you got those types of dongles that are crazy cheap and crazy powerful as it turns out, with all their features for Bluetooth, NFC and so on. And if you want to make a device that is more compact and more embedded, you actually got those type of modules that are going to be already predefined. And finally, you can actually just buy the chip and design the radio yourself. The advantage of those types of modules is simply going to be that they are already certified regarding the radio, and so you can directly use it, and in some cases, certification translates directly to your product, to be your entire product being certified thanks to the module itself being certified and you not having made any modification to the radio. Typically, the modules that I use here are the BMD-340. Those are fairly cheap, actually. Very compact and very powerful than the NI-52 line of microcontroller. Fantastic. Now, the question is like, how do you program them, actually? You're gonna have to plug it in, but you don't have any USB or anything. It's not like an Arduino where you've got a bootloader already on it that is helping you, making your life easier. Then you're gonna have to use a proper programmer. By default, the programmer that is recommended is going to be the J-Link programmer. That programmer is perfectly fine, but it is extremely expensive. And I would much rather use a more compact and way cheaper device. For example, that ST-Link. Typically, this one costed me around $2 on the internet. That's most certainly a Chinese clone. That's why it's so cheap, but it works perfectly well. So typically in this application, you're gonna have your microcontroller that goes here, or actually the module itself, and it's laid out so that the programming connector is gonna be here. You're gonna have a regular header, and you got the tag connector that is gonna be this cable here that is directly connecting to it, and that you can easily unplug and replug to reprogram. That connector is connected to a board that I designed to actually explode it to pin so that I can plug it easily. And finally, you got your connection to the ST-Link itself connected to the laptop. The whole point of that system here that I'm talking about is to use a cheap programmer. Obviously, the cable is not cheap at all, but the connection can be done in whichever way. For example, here I could have used the headers that are already included in the PCB. But I got the cable, so might as well use it. So in this setup, we're gonna have the programmer that is gonna be connected with the ground, the SWCLK, the SWDIO, and on the side we got a power supply providing energy to the system. I'm using that oscilloscope connector cable hook to actually connect multiple devices on the same ground. To actually be able to use the ST-Link, we're gonna have to install some programmer on our laptop to actually communicate with. The one we're gonna use is OpenOCD that you're gonna have to actually download from that link and build yourself. It's fairly simple, just to make file inside of it, so you just make install and you're good to go. But the reason why you need to do that is, at least me on my Ubuntu, the OpenOCD that is provided with the packages is too old and does not include the configuration for the NI-52 microcontroller that we are using here. So, need to download the latest version and build it and install it. Fairly straightforward, but need to do that. Then you're gonna have to build your own application that you wanna put in your microcontroller. We're not gonna dive deeper into that in that video, but you got many examples that are provided inside of the SDK that Nordic gives you. Then, using the makefile that the Nordic company is giving us, we're just gonna edit it to actually use the OpenOCD program to send the program to the microcontroller. So here we are in the makefile that is provided, and we have just modified the flash function to use OpenOCD. In that one, we're gonna have to give it a few information. First of all, that folder, the TCL folder, where it can actually get more information about the installation of OpenOCD. Then we're gonna have to specify the interface that we use. In our case, it's the ST-Link. If you check in that folder, you've got many, many other types of programmers that you could use. In that case, I haven't tried them myself. The ST-Link is perfectly fine for me and difficult to beat regarding price. Then we're going to set up the configuration of the microcontroller that we're using, the NI-52 in our case. That's the specific part that is the reason why we had to build the OpenOCD ourselves instead of using the one in the packages of Ubuntu. And then with the -C, we're going to be able to send comments to the microcontroller, or more likely to the programmer, to actually send our binary file. We start with an init of the programmer, we reset and init the microcontroller somehow, and then we can actually program the X file that we just built before. We reset the microcontroller and we can exit. This command is valid for the program that we are doing. If you want to flash something else, I don't know, a soft device, for example, which would be appropriate on an audit microcontroller, we're going to have to call OpenOCD again to actually send the soft device. That's what we are doing here, where we are programming the S140 soft device to the microcontroller. The command is exactly the same, we're just using another hex file. Because of the way it's built, with the hex file, you don't have to specify any addresses or anything. Everything is already included inside of the hex file, so the programming command is very generic. So typically in that case, what we're going to do is just some very, very basic program where we're going to actually turn on the LED that is available on the PCB. So for that here, we configure the LED pin as an output, we set it too high to actually turn on the LED, and that's it. We're just gonna make the program and call the command that we just created in the make file using make flash. This is gonna program the microcontroller and we can see the LED turning on. So there you go. I hope this video helps you actually waste less time than me on figuring out how to program your microcontroller. As always, if you got a better solution or if you found something that is weird or wrong that I did, please leave it in the comment. I'm more than happy to learn how to make things better. Thank you for watching. Bye. Bye.